Hello everyone, welcome back again in the yet another session of flower arrangement. In this session we'll be discussing and understanding the principles of flower arrangement. In a way you can say that these are some of the important guidelines or some of the pointers, rules that you have to keep in mind while you are making any of the flower arrangement. Though this entirely depends upon the creativity. You can play with your creativity, but these basic guidelines and rules have to be kept in mind. In the previous session of the flower arrangement, we understood about various equipments and materials which are required to create an aesthetic floral arrangement. In this session, after understanding the principles of flower arrangement, the student will be able to apply those 8 principles, important principles to attain a good design and aesthetic floral appeal in the arrangement. So let's move forward with the session, principles of flower arrangement. The very first principle is the design or the shape. Anybody who is going to make a flower arrangement should have a design or a structure in their mind before starting, so that you can collect all the plant material, all the flowers, foliage, container accordingly. The shape, size and color of your leaves, of your flowers can depends very much on the design that you are going to make. So be very careful and very particular with shape. For example, if you want to make a triangle shape, or you want to go for a side triangle shape, or you want to make a circular flower arrangement. Accordingly, depending upon the design and the shape, the entire plant material depends. The next principle is scale and proportion. The scale and proportion can be understood here in terms of the relationship which is between the flower and the container. Both have to complement each other so that you can see a complete balance. For example, you can say if you have a flat container, you have chosen a flat container, so height of your flower arrangement and the plant material has to be maintained accordingly. Again, choosing lots of flowers or choosing a very less flower in comparison to the size of your container again will be a disbalance and will not fulfill the rule of scale and proportion. If you are using flowers with different colors, go for a plain texture or a plain color container. In the image also, third image, you can see that the first image where a decorated and patterned container has been used is not giving that look or that balance which the other side by arrangement is creating. Similarly, the size, structure and the number of plant material, flower sticks, everything has to be in balance with each other, plus the area and location for which you are making the plant material. The third principle is the balance. Now this balance can be symmetrical and it can be asymmetrical. Symmetrical balance will be that which gives you the mirror image on both the sides. So if you draw a line in the center, it is going to give you a somewhat symmetrical mirror image. But for the asymmetrical part, it will not be the same. But yet, in the flower arrangement, you can go for an asymmetrical flower arrangement, keeping in mind that your container, the height, color, the length, plus the flowers, plant material and the design that you have chosen has to be aesthetically appealing to the eyes. In simple words, we can say that the main motive of balance in the flower arrangement is to create an equal distribution of the eyes full or the weight of your eyes. Either your eyes should go in one of the direction. When you are looking at any of the flower arrangement, it should not be that your eyes are moving haphazardly and it is confused, but rather the focus has to be that the eye movement has to be in a very systematic manner. This can be created through your color, your flower material, plant material, and the design. Next principle is the focal point. Focal point means if you want to create a centerpiece or if you want to create the emphasis in your flower arrangement. Means if you want that the looker, the person who is looking, the eye movement or the focus you want to draw at a certain flower or a certain point, say in the center of the flower arrangement, you have to create a focal point. This focal point in the flower arrangement can be done by adding any of the different color flower material or a different size flower, maybe at the center or very beautifully placed at the desired area and place, so that once a person looks into the flower arrangement, the focus automatically will first of all very well land on this focal point which has been created. So it depends. It is not necessary that every flower arrangement should have a focal point. But yes, if you want or create, you want to achieve a focal point, you can go for it. The next principle is the rhythm. Now, what do we mean by rhythm? Your all previous four principles, if they are met in a flower arrangement, automatically the rhythm is created. It is the movement of your plant material in terms of the color, shape, the size, the pattern which you have created, plus the area, the background. Everything has to be interconnected with each other. Your eyes, movement of the eye should be from one direction and ending to the other direction. It can be either from the left to right or from right to left. It depends. Next, very important is the harmony. Again, the harmony in terms of the balance, scale, rhythm, design that you have chosen will create a complete harmony and will set the mood of the environment. Will look aesthetically appealing and the quality will increase. Every plant material that has been chosen, all the foliages, fillers, sides, everything will be complementing each other and creating a harmony as a whole. Next, very important is the texture. So when you are making your flower arrangement, be very specific for choosing the flowers, the leaves that you are going to choose. The texture of flower material, it can be very coarse, it can be smooth, soft, it can have or give you a satin look also. Different textures can be added to create the attention of the viewer. So be very specific and choose the contrasting textures to create entirely a different look. Last but not the least and very, very important is the color combination. You know that colors add life too. So color has to be a dynamic factor. Colors of the background, your container, your plant material has to be in the equal composition. It should not be that you are going for one color very much which is seen plus the other color is not visible, or the colors are too bright to complement each other. So keep a balanced pattern of colors to create a good feel and the look. That was all from my side. Thank you so much. In the next session, we'll be understanding and we'll be looking upon different styles of flower arrangement, different designs which can be created or which are available. Till then, thank you so much and enjoy your day. If you have any queries, please be in touch. See you soon. Thank you.